In the name of God, today I want to explain three attractive cinematic effects in Premiere for you. Before anything, if you haven't installed Premiere yet, from the link I put at the top of the page, you can watch the installation tutorial. Well, let's go for the first cinematic effect. This effect that I want to explain to you is used to blur or invert the blur so that you can cover part of your video and blur it. In this footage, we want the subject's face to be clear and the area around it, which is a bit blurry. We want to make it more blurry at the surf. Well, for this, first we search for blur in the effects section so that the Gaussian blur, which you can see here, appears for us. We drag this onto our footage, we go to the effect control section, and from this part in Gaussian blur in the blurriness section, we increase this amount to the desired amount. Well, you can see that our subject is also blurred and her face is not clear at all. To remove his face from the blur, we create a mask for it. Well, we select this mask, which is circular, and place it exactly on his face and the parts that we don't want to be blurred. Like this. Now we want this to be reversed. To reverse the work, there is an inverted check mark here. We check it and we see that it's reversed to soften this border between the blur and the part that is not blurred again. From the effect control section in Gaussian blur, here mask feather, we increase this amount a bit so that the blur is softer. Well, you see that it is a bit softer. Now we can make it even more so. Okay, well, let's see the result. Very good. Let's go for the second cinematic effect. To create the second cinematic effect, we re-import the clip into the timeline. I chose the clip that thought is suitable for this. Okay, well, I'll play it so we can see what it's like. We don't want to make this clip a bit more attractive and watchable. Well, for this, from the effects section, we type poster and select the posterized time effect and drag it onto our clip. Well, after doing this, from the effect control section, we change the frame rate, which is 24 to 5. Depending on the clip you choose and your taste, you can change this number. Well, I put it on the number 5 and now I play it. You see that it is like this. It turned out well. If you want this effect to be played to a part of it and not to the other part, press the C key on the keyboard and here you cut the footage. Then again, press the V key on the keyboard and select this section. We click on posterize time and press the delete key on the keyboard so that the effect we applied only applies to the first part. Okay, let's see the result. It's like this. And when it enters this part, it becomes very, very smooth. Dear friends, so you don't miss our next video, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon. I selected this footage in the effects section. We type mirror and we apply the mirror effect to our footage. From the effect control section, we change the reflection angle from to negative 90 degrees. We see that our image turned out like this and it became a negative 90 degree mirror reflection look itself. In the reflection center section, you can increase or decrease this value and change the number 540. Now is a suitable number 381. To write text in this empty section, click on the T in the tools section and we define its boundary like this and type our desired text. Okay, then we press the V key on the keyboard and we can move this like this. In this way. Okay, let's see. You can even give it a nice motion like this. From the position section, press the stopwatch button and move the text outside of the selection box. Then as you move forward a bit, you increase the number like this. Okay, let's see the result. like this to make our clip more cinematic. There's another thing you can do. In the project or bin section, this part we create a color matte. And here this size is good. We click OK and set its color to black. We click OK. Again, OK, and we see that a black matte appeared here. OK, we drag this over all the layers and you see it's black. To remove this blackness from the effects section, we type crop and we apply crop to our color matte. We set top to 90 and we see that a black bar was created at the bottom. To place this bar at the top of the image as well, while holding the Alt key, we click on the color matte and copy it one layer above. We select the top layer color matte and in the crop section, we change this value, which we previously changed to 90, to 0. And in the bottom section, we change this 0 to 90. Well, look, with this simplicity and beauty, you can use this effect for various tasks and even for wedding projects. I hope you are successful and make good use of these effects.